Hello student, my name is Bharki Dipkaral from LG Institute of Engineering and Technology. Welcome to my online lecture series of Basics of Automotive System. So today we will discuss a new topic about the transmission system, in which previous lectures we will covered the classification of our transmission system. So now let me discuss about the different types of transmission system, or we can say a gearbox. Okay, different types of gearbox. So let me start. We basically divided into the two parts: manual type of transmission system or automatic transmission system or manual transmission system. In manual transmission system, basically three types are there. Okay, first, basically in that manual transmission system, the first one is a sliding mass gearbox, and second one is a constant mass gearbox, and third one is the synchromesh gearbox. Okay, in manual you have these three types. Let me discuss the one by one, because these three types of gearbox is a very important for exam point of view. So in the exams, one of the gearbox asked in the exam. So in the total transmission system chapters, we covered these three types of gearbox, and another is the automatic, like CVT and torque converter and selector mechanism, and then we will move for the electrical drive. Okay, so this total chapters covered it, these topics only. Okay, so let first we discuss about the sliding mass gearbox. The simple construction which are shown in this diagram, these are nothing but the sliding mass gearbox. Okay, these are the sliding mass gearbox. Simple in construction, it is a very oldest type of gearbox. Sliding mass type of gearbox is a very oldest type of manual transmission used in automobile. Okay, so it consists of different types of part, like output shaft. So where is output shaft? This shaft is nothing but your output shaft, or we can say main shaft. Okay, let me discuss in the these diagrams. Okay, first we explain this diagram, which component is one. So this shaft is nothing but clutch shaft, which is connected from the engine shaft. Okay, or we can say engine. So the RPM of engine is same as this clutch shaft. Over the clutch shaft we connected a clutch gear. Okay, so this is known as the clutch gear, on which projection gear are provided, or we can say teeth projection on the that gear is provided. And another shaft is nothing but counter shaft or lay shaft. Okay, this shaft is known as a counter shaft and lay shaft, over which different gear or of different size are provided on that lay shaft, so that it is continuously the rotation because of it connected with this clutch shaft. If it is rotated, so that this gear is connected to this shaft, and this is nothing but we can say compounding, one type of compounding. Why it is known as a compounding? Because over the one shaft different gears are mounted on the only one shaft. That means the speed of that all the gears are same, the speed of the all the gears are same, because it is a compounding. So these gears is known as a connected on the lay shaft. Another shaft is the main shaft, over which these two gear are provided. So for this diagram only two gears are provided, depends on you. So we explain here these two gears. So these two gears are rigidly connected over this shaft, okay, with the help of spline. So okay, so in this shaft spline are provided. So by providing this spline, it can move on this shaft in this direction, or either on in reverse direction or forward direction, because spline shaft is used. Due to spline, this gear is also internality, so that it can move reverse and forward direction. And for this movement we use the selector mechanism, and this selector mechanism is connected to the this knob, lever knob, and we can say gear changing lever. Okay, so by providing this gear changing lever, we can move this gear right or left. Okay, so these are the main component of construction of this gear. So we use the low or reverse sliding gearbox. One more gear is used on that last gear, that is a idler gear. This idler gear, or this idler gear, is nothing but it is used to change the direction of the main shaft. Okay, suppose these two gear is used, what happened? let us consider if it is rotated in anti-clockwise direction, that means it rotates in a clockwise direction. This all the gears rotate in clockwise direction. When it is contact with this gear, that means it rotates in again anti-clockwise direction. Okay, so it is anti-clockwise direction, this is clockwise direction, and all the gears have same direction, and this rotate in anti-clockwise direction when it is moving. So if the both gear has same rotation, if we want to the rotation of the both gear shaft, we use one more gear, that is the idler gear. So the function of this idler gear is nothing but to give the same direction so that the vehicle can move in a reverse direction. Okay, or we use for this reverse, when this gear is contact with this gear, that means your vehicle will move in a reverse direction. That's why it is known as a reverse gear. Okay, so let me understand, this is the output shaft, low and reverse sliding gearbox, second sliding gear and clutch, input shaft, clutch gear, counter shaft, driver gear, counter shaft, low speed gear and second gear, reverse idler gear and gear shift fork. Okay. So what happened? Let me understand the construction of this working of this gearbox. When it transmits a power from the clutch shaft to this gear, the power is transmitted to this shaft. Okay, and this one speed is the same. And that when we apply the first gear, what happened? By selector mechanism, this selector, this gear moves on that and this contact with this gear. Okay. So what happened? The first gear is applied, and in that case, the torque is maximum, speed is less, because this gear is small compared to this one, and this is a big gear is used. So this is our first gear. Now, that means power is transmitted from here to here. Now, what happened? We apply a second gear. Before we apply a second gear, we first use the declutching, or we can say this gear it comes in the neutral condition. First it moves in that direction, and by using of the second selector mechanism, this gear is contact with this gear and we apply a second gear. So RPM increases and torque reduces because the size of this one is the less compared to this one. Okay, so just it is a diagram, but consider the my language what happened in that case. Okay, now the second gear is applied. Now what is the final gears, or we can say last gear. Okay, so third gear is the last gear, and this last gear is nothing but the speed of the clutch shaft or is equal to the main shaft. That means that condition, what happened? First this it comes in neutral condition by selector mechanism, this move in that direction, or we can say in that direction or for left direction, and we apply a gear changing lever to this gear. Okay, directly more connected with the clutch gear. How it connected? Here we provided the dogs, or we can say projection gear, and here also meshing projection gear. So both the gears are connected. This both the gears are connected, and power is directly transmitted to the this shaft. Okay, not and this shaft rotate itself nothing but it's not to use. Okay, and power is transmitted to direct to main shaft. That means speed of the clutch shaft is equal to the main shaft. So this is the working of the sliding gearbox. So let me see this diagram. The first gear is power is transmitted from here to here, and second gear power is transmitted to the second gear, and this blue rotation is nothing but the direction of the other shaft. Okay, this is the direction of the shaft, and this is the third gear, power is transmitted from here to here. So when we apply the final gear, or we can say fourth gear, or we can say one gem when dog is dogged, that means dog is nothing but the projection on that both the gear, clutch gear and the that gear, both are the meshing with this dogged, or we can say projections or provided. So it can mesh directly, that means power is directly transferred to this. So okay, without going to the lay shaft. Okay, power is nothing not to going to the lay shaft. That means it is directly connected, and this is known as a dogged clutch, and power is nothing but speed ratio is nothing but 1 J1. Now, what is the reverse gear? Reverse gear is applying by the this idler gear. We use the idler gear. Power is come to this lay shaft and it transmits to the one more shaft is used on which idler gear is used. This idler gear is a thing, but it is used to change the direction of the rotation. Okay, and this, then it transmits to this gears. So that is the our total 4 gear plus 1 reverse gear. So this is the functions and diagrams of sliding based gearbox, how it works. Okay, but why it is known as sliding? Because it slides over that main shaft. That's why it is known as a sliding gearbox. But the mechanical efficiency is very low and noise level are very quite high. But moreover, the drivers required considerable skill of the changing the gear. So it, in that case, the drivers required more skill, or we can say more effort to changing the gears. So that's why we use another gears, that is a constant mass gearbox. In that case, the improvement of this all the things which improved, which result in higher mechanical efficiency or lower noise level due to use of helical gear. In that case, we use helical gear instead of spur gear. In that case, we use the spur gear, but you may use the helical gear also. Okay. So the next we will move on the a constant mass gearbox. Okay, so this is the animation of the sliding mass gearbox. We have to it. These are nothing but the selector mechanism to select the our gear. This is our fourth gear which is connected to here, and this is the output shaft, or we can say main shaft. These are the clutch gear we used, counter shaft here. Okay. This is second gears we use here. Next is constant mass gearbox. This is one of the famous type of used in the 20th century. In this gearbox, all the gears are in constant mesh with each other. Okay, but what happened in previous slide? The gears are not constantly meshed. Whenever we require to engage in the gears, we use the slides over the spline shaft. Okay, so we use that. But in that constant mesh, gear is constantly contact with the each other. The gear on the main shaft rotates freely without rotating the main shaft. Okay, so gear on whatever gears on the main shaft which is freely rotating by providing the bush and gear bearing. Okay, in constant mesh gearbox consists of two dog clutch. This clutch are providing on the main shaft, one between the clutch gear and second gear, and the other between the first gear and reverse gear. That means two dog clutch, or we can say double declutching, is provided when the left side of dog clutch is made to slide left by means of gear shift lever. It meshes with the clutch gear and vehicle runs on top speed. Okay, if this clutch slides right and the mesh with the second gear, then the vehicle runs on the second gear speed. So in constant mesh gear box, we can change the gear ratio by shifting the dog clutch. Okay. This type of gearbox is more popular than sliding mesh gearbox because it creates a low noise and less gear. Let me understand this gearbox. Okay, what happens? These are the nothing but our the clutching by clutch pedals here, and these are the clutch shaft, and here clutch gear is provided here, and these are the lay shaft over which different gears are provided here. Okay, and these are the main shaft over which different gears are provided. Okay, but these gears are constantly connected with each other, but this gear is freely rotated by providing the bearing over here and not the spine shaft we used here. Okay, and how it works and how it different from that sliding mesh gearbox? It is a constantly slide with each other, so power is transmitted from here. Okay, from this clutch gear, and it rotates all the gears are rotated. Okay, the speed of these gears are same as because it transfer to here, but this all the gears are maybe different speed because of it is really mounted. Okay, the main shaft is not rotated at right now. So how the gear is shifting? The gear is shifting by use of this dog clutches are provided here. Dog clutches is nothing but the projection. This is the dog clutch. We known as a dog clutch. Over which this is projections. Okay, and similarly the projection provided on this all the gears. Okay, whenever we require to shifting the gear, what happens if this gears by using of this lever. Okay, this is move in that direction. Suppose it moves in the left direction, that means it messes with here. That means the speed is independent, not constrained, that means not freely rotate this gear. So power is transmitted from here to here.
So this is the lay shaft and main shaft we use. How it works? So dog clutch is move on that left side, then it meshes with these gears. Okay, so that meshes with this gear. So what happened here, the speed of, because this dog clutch is rigidly mounted on the main shaft and this is the freely rotated on that gears with the help of this gear, and when it is meshed with here, so speed is locked in. That means these both the are the locked. That means no relative motion between these two, so that it have a same speed. So power is transmitted from here to here, and that means the gear is shifting like this. Okay, the gear 1, gear 2 is here, and gear 3, 4, and like this. All how it works, this dog clutch is fitted with these gears. Okay, with the help of this projection, or we can say teeth are provided on that gears and this dog clutch. Okay, so it combines with that, and so that the motion is prevented. So the power is transmitted from this this clutch gear through this gear, and lay shaft is the same speed. So this gear rotation of this gear is transferred to this gear, and this gear is power is transmitted to dog clutch to the main shaft. That main shaft is rotates. Okay, because while you shift this gear knob, or we can say the gear, okay, gear lever, with the help of this selector mechanism, this move in the left direction. Okay, similarly, if it is a move in that direction, or we can say a right direction, that dog clutch is connected with this gears, and that times one gear is used in between of these two gears, lay shaft and the main shaft, this gear is known as a idler gear, so that it provides a reverse gear. How it reverse, this shaft is rotating in the reverse direction, so that that times your vehicle will move in a reverse direction. So it is an idler gear to change the direction of the shaft. Okay, main shaft. So this is reverse gear. This is the gear 1. Similarly, gear 2, 3, and 4. So these types of gear we can shift by using of the selector mechanisms. Okay. So the function of this dog clutch is nothing but to prevent the relative motions, and because this gear is really rotate on that shaft with the help of bearing and bush. So this is the working of the sliding gearbox. So this is the gear selector mechanism, gear 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and reverse gear, the function. Let's this is in power from the engine, the rotation from engine to this clutch gear, and this is transferred to this one. These gears are always in contact, that's why it is known as a constant match gearbox. How the first gear is applied, when we move the knob in that direction, left direction, that means it connected with this gear 1. So this is a big gears. Okay, this big gear, this is small gear. Okay, the size of the gear is varying on the lay shaft. So power is transferred to this first gear, and this is connected with each other with the help of the selector fork. Okay, this move in that direction. So what happens, the size of this gear 1 is a big compared to this gear, so that the torque is more, the speed is less to achieve. Okay, and then this lay shaft or this main shaft is connected to differential mechanism. Okay, similarly gear 2, the size is reduced compared to, and this size is increased. That's why gear 2 is with the help of same gear selector, but it move in a right side. Okay, that's why this meshing with each other, and the gear 2 is applied. It similarly gear 3 and 4, gear 4, 5 and reverse are same. Okay, 5 and reverse are applied by this dog clutch. 3 and 4 is applied by this dog clutch, and 2 and 1 is applied by this dog clutch. Okay, so here I think 3 shaft are there. Okay, 3 road we used in this gear selector mechanism, which are not shown in that diagrams. Okay, so this is the animations of the how gear is applied, how to gear ratio. This is downward. Okay, gear 2 is applied. This is the neutral, and then gear 3, gear 4, gear 5. Okay, so this is the engaging condition, these are disengaging conditions. Okay, gear 4. Okay, this is the knob. Okay, gear reverse here. Okay, this is dog clutch wheel. So this is the examples we can see how the gear ratio will be changed. Okay.
advantages of the constant mass gearbox over the sliding mass gearbox. Quicker gearing can be achieved. That means that speedily, or we can say fastly, we achieve the gearing. Okay, and only damage occurs on the Doppler teeth, not teeth of the gear wheel. Synchronizing device can be used for smooth engagement of the gear. Once the dog clutch are engaged, there is no motion between their teeth, but the power is transmitted through the sliding action on the teeth on one wheel to those of the other. The gear teeth are engaged to transmit a motion properly. The teeth are suitably spaced. Next is a synchromesh gearbox. This is a very, very important gearbox. Synchromesh gearbox, nowadays this gearbox is very used. One big problem occurs in the constant mesh gearbox is that when the driver engages the dog clutch, the main shaft and gear to be meshed running at different speed. So when engaged, this gear causes a wear and tear, more and wear and tear in the dog clutch. That means during running condition, when it engages, the problem of more wear vibration is there. Okay, this problem is solved by that synchromesh gearbox. Okay, this gearbox is same as the constant mesh gearbox, except instead of dog clutch, which is replaced by, we use a synchromesh devices. Okay, in that synchromesh gearbox, dog clutch is replaced by the synchromesh devices. What is synchromesh devices? Let me see in the next slide. Synchromesh gear device work on the principle of two gear to be engaged are first brought into the friction contact with the equalize their speed. The two gear are used in third. The first is brought into the friction contact. We like a clutch. Like clutch plate. The first like work as a like a clutch plate. Okay. The friction contact is used so that the speed is equal. And after which they are engaged readily or smoothly and then engaged. The synchromesh looks like as a cone clutch. It looks like a cone clutch where the other surface of the cone consists of friction surface. This type of gearbox is widely used in automobile. How, let me see it, how it like. So suppose is a cone clutch. Similarly, this is the another. Okay, so first friction is here, friction is provided here, okay, and then engaged engaging position we used. Okay, the first engage, so we first equalize the speed, okay, and then engage. Okay, let me understand this diagram very clearly. These are known as the synchromesh. Okay, instead of the dog clutch, these are our gear. Okay, the clutch shaft is here. This is our clutch gear. This is the lay shaft over which gear. These are constantly meshed. That's why the advancement or improvement of the constant mesh gearbox, or we can say it is the modification of the constant mesh gearbox. Okay. This type of gearbox is similar to constant mesh in that gear is a main layout is constantly meshed with the corresponding gear on lay shaft. Okay. The gear on the layout shaft is fixed to it while those on the main shaft are free to rotate on the chain. Okay. Its working is also similar to constant mesh gearbox, but in the former there is a one definite improvement over the latter. Okay, this is the provision of synchromesh device which avoid the necessity of the double declutching. Okay, the parts which ultimately are to be engaged first brought into the friction contact which equalize their speed, after which they is engaged and smoothly. Okay, so let me understand these diagrams. What happened here? These are the two divided into two parts. This upper side is the teeth. Below side is also provided. So first it is engaged with here, so speed is equalized. When it moves, suppose like when it moves in that direction, okay, this bushing are provided here. Okay, when it moves in a dead direction, that is contact between these two, so by the friction forces here, so that the speed is equalized. And next, the here we provided the internal teeth and here we provided the external teeth. By providing this teeth, it meshes, rigidly meshes with this one, so that the power is transmitted to this main shaft. So this is the mechanism of the sliding mesh gearbox. Okay, these are the cross sections view. Okay, what the things are here? High pressure pipe, master cylinder is there. This is the, when we applied the clutch pedals, engage, disengaging. Okay, these are the gear mechanism where which electric are used. input shaft, output shaft is there, okay, friction clutch is there, dual mass flywheel is there, gear actuation mechanism we use, these are the synchronizers we use. Okay, the main transmission offers a better fuel economy advantages over their automatic counterparts. Manual transmission are cheaper than the automatic transmission and require less maintenance than the automatic one. A person driving a car with the manual transmission has a direct control over the car than a person who is driving the car with automatic transmission. A car with the manual transmission provides an extra throttle while overtaking, since the driver can move the lower gear for more power. Automatic transmission, on the other hand, has delayed reaction time. A car fitted with the manual transmission requires a greater degree of control and involvement from the driver than a car with the automatic transmission. What is the disadvantages? This driving a car with the manual transmission requires a greater degree of skill. That means the knowledge or skill is required more, and application and inexperienced driver could have his hand full while driving, as he has to multitask and concentrate on a lot of things simultaneously. While climbing up hill, okay, or we can gradient, a car with automatic transmission always score over the one with manual. In a manual transmission, smooth and effective shifting of gear can only be guaranteed by the experienced drivers. Okay, these are the gear shifting mechanisms. The gear shifting lever can be located either on the steering, on the steering column, or for using it for the shifting gears. Okay, steering column gear shifting mechanism used on a car, while footboard type is used in commercial vehicle, Jeep, medium and vehicle ones. Okay, the gear shifting mechanism is used for changing gears. Okay, this mechanism is used for changing gears easily and selecting the required gear train and bringing the selected gear into the operation. For engaging the slots on the gearbox, it is the consisting of the fork on the gearbox. Next is, in neutral position, what happened? It is provided with the free slide way moment in either way. Okay, in case of steering column gear, two types. In steering column gear, change the arrangement in the free movement in the up and down direction. The floor type of shifting mechanism is less costly, is required less maintenance. Into a slot at the top of both of the selector fork, the tip of the gear shift lever is fitted. The steering column type shifting mechanism. Steering column type shifting mechanism can be operated easily, as driver has a move his hand through the short distance and the fork compartment space of the vehicle is more. It is difficult to learn the operator of steering column shifting mechanism. It is complex, need and more maintenance, and its cost. These are the mechanism how to gear is shifting. Let me understand these diagrams. This is our knob, lever knob, and push two rod or two shaft, upper gear and lever and ball. These both shafts are connected with the ball and socket joint, and location pin is connected to these two shafts. Okay. These are the selector gates. So this is the selector gates. Okay, lower gear levers. Okay. How it works? Okay, these are the selectors which engaged with the gears. Okay, which movement to slide the gear. This one, and this one. Okay, selector rods. These three rods are used. And here this rod is used for the first and second gears. When it moves in that direction, this is the second gear. When it moves in that direction, it moves first gear. Similarly here, if it moves in that direction, this is the first gear. It moves in the direction second gear when it engages with this one. How it works? First, it moves in that direction. In that direction, that means it shifted on that shaft. And when it moves in that moving in that direction, that is the gear first is applied. It when it moves here and it applied in that direction, that means gear 2 is applied. It similarly gear 4 and 3 on that lever, which is provided here. This is a for two sliding the gear. Okay, similarly reverse gear and fourth gear is provided with the help of this one. Okay, notched grooves are provided here, and this is reverse and fork. Okay, reverse lever and fork lever. So these are the selector mechanisms used to apply the gears. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4 and reverse gear. Okay, spring and ball plungers is provided here, first and second gears for selector. This is the location pin. So this diagram is for the selector mechanism. Thank you so much.